Developing a laboratory safety program. Developing a lab safety program is equally the responsibility of the management and the technical authorities. An ongoing program to review safe operations and equipment should be developed. Work sites should be surveyed or inspected periodically to ensure compliance with all safety policies and procedures, including use of personal protective equipment, handling of sharps and hazardous waste, appropriate exposure follow-up, documentation of inspection of firefighting apparatus, etc. The following strategy may be employed in developing a safety program and inculcating a safety culture. Designating a safety officer for the facility or each department should be the starting point. A laboratory safety manual should be developed, identifying all the risk areas and defining procedures for preventive and mitigating measures. It would be ideal to do a baseline risk assessment and analyze the data. A prioritization matrix may be employed to identify areas needing urgent intervention. Strategies should be defined to address the deficiencies. Training to the staff for safe work practices should be given. Reporting of hazards, non-conforming events, and incidents should be encouraged. Reporting ensures proper treatment and follow-up, financial compensation if necessary, engineering or procedure changes. To make reporting uniform and to capture all non-conformities and incidents, a quality indicator system with safety indicators tool may be developed. Areas of challenge may be selected for quality improvement and goals and objectives may be set. Contingency plans and emergency procedures. A written contingency plan for dealing with laboratory accidents is a necessity and should provide operational procedures for precautions against natural disasters, example, fire, flood, earthquake and explosions, biohazard risk assessment, incident exposure management, example, needle stick injury and decontamination, emergency evacuation, team protocols for evacuation, emergency medical treatment of exposed and injured persons, medical surveillance of exposed persons, clinical management of exposed persons, epidemiological investigation, post-incident continuation of operations. In the development of this plan, following items should be considered: identification of high-risk organisms, identification of high-risk activities, location of high-risk areas, example, laboratories, storage areas. Identification of areas which may be overlooked during an emergency evacuation. Identification of at-risk personnel and populations. Identification of responsible personnels and their duties, example, safety officer. Lists of treatment and isolation facilities that can receive exposed or infected people. Transport of exposed or infected persons. Lists of sources of immune serum, vaccines, drugs, etc. Provision of emergency equipment, example, PPE, disinfectants, chemical and biological spill kits, decontamination equipment and supplies. For more details on developing a lab safety program, refer to the training module on facility management and safety.